Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Today's video will not be very long at all and will almost entirely consist of Boca Chica and Starship updates. So let's head straight in and get up to date. First up, similarly to the last episode, we actually have another update on the launch of Starlink 9. Delayed many times this month, this mission was expected to be the last of July's launches. However, as you can see on the SpaceXFans website, that has now changed once again. Hopefully now, the vehicle should lift off on Saturday, August 1st at 7:21am UTC or 3:21am EDT. There is also some news with regards to the crew that will fly aboard the Dragon Endeavour capsule for the Crew 2 mission. Like with the Crew 1 mission, 4 astronauts will fly to the International Space Station for Crew 2. Those men and women are Shane Kimbra, Megan MacArthur, who are both American astronauts. Then there's also JAXA astronaut Akihiko Hoshide and ESA astronaut Thomas Peskett. Something interesting I want to mention is that Megan MacArthur is actually Bob Behnken's wife. So Bob flew on Crew Dragon Endeavour for the first time and his wife will fly on the third crewed Dragon flight and the second flight for the Endeavour capsule. That's it for the standard SpaceX updates because, as I said, not much except updates in Boca Chica. To start with, you can see that the SpaceX facility got quite a bit of flooding, mostly by the roads. However, apparently the brunt of Tropical Storm Hanna hit north of Boca Chica, so the facility didn't experience too much of it. As always, even more deliveries were spotted arriving. Here we have some new rolls of stainless steel. Most likely rolls of 304L stainless since at the moment that's what SpaceX are using to build their prototypes. Since it's relevant to the last point, thought I would show you the enormous and growing collection of rolls. This pile of stainless steel rolls has been accumulating for some months. I can imagine a bunch of it is probably for Super Heavy. Next up, we recently saw some new groundwork being done over by the production area. Boca Chica Maria a little while ago suggested it was being done for a parking lot. Here we have a view of the work and it looks very much to me like it is indeed a parking lot. Also, nearby this new area, the ground fabrication building was spotted with the door slightly open. We recently saw engineers working on what is being called the crew office arm. Similarly to what we've seen before around the SpaceX facility, this is a shipping container converted into offices. Except, with these offices you can see that SpaceX have styled it to look like the crew access arm. Also, you can see the structure being attached to the fabrication building has progressed and is looking almost complete. With the tropical storm, Bluezilla had to be folded down so it didn't risk getting blown over. As a result, the high bay construction has paused temporarily, but here is the latest view of the giant structure. That's it for this video in terms of infrastructure updates, but let's take a look at Starship Pieces. To begin with, as expected, shortly after the storm passed, the new nose cones were once again moved back outside. Jack Bayer, with his great editing, pointed out something on one of these nose cones. Here you can see what could be a potential mounting point for the canards. However, now it's time to look at SN5, which has long been awaiting a static fire. On Monday, SpaceX began preparing for the first static fire for this vehicle by closing the road and clearing the pad. However, unfortunately, this first attempt had to be scrubbed due to an issue. After the scrub, NASA Spaceflight tweeted about the SpaceX's returning to the pad. Musk responded to this tweet with more information about why it had to be scrubbed. He said, "I was just out at the launch pad, connector damaged in the storm but fixed now, might be able to fire tonight or at least get to the next issue." Even though this first attempt was scrubbed, SpaceX were able to do some important testing. You can see here that they did some testing of the RCS thrusters. Not necessarily required for the static fire, but definitely needed for the hop. Then, as Musk mentioned was a possibility, later into the evening, once again they began by clearing the pad, fueling the prototype and preparing for a second static fire attempt. However, unfortunately, this test was delayed yet again. After another tweet by Chris Burgin asking Elon Musk about the second abort and when to expect the next test attempt, Elon Musk didn't hesitate to respond. He said, "Fuel spin valve didn't open, we'll fix and try again tomorrow, also some odd thrust vector control hydraulic pump behaviour." Engineers were obviously spotted working underneath the vehicle to look at the issues Musk mentioned. Like usual, let's also take a look at the currently scheduled road and beach closures. As of right now, the days we can expect for testing again are today and tomorrow. Obviously, it goes without saying, but as much as there could be a test over the next couple of days, it could also be delayed again. So once again, disappointing news with regards to the testing of the SN5 prototype. However, here we have some really cool footage to show of Zeus the RoboDog doing his job and inspecting the SN5 tank. If you don't know, Zeus is a spot robot and has been adapted to include more cameras, I believe. The first time Zeus was spotted in action was to inspect the SN7 test tank after its very much scheduled rapid disassembly. I wasn't expecting to be able to add anything for SN8, but some footage has come out. Here we have a downcomer, and this will go down from the methane tank through the oxygen tank to feed propellant down into the thrust section. Here you can see it's labelled SN10 equals SN8 Boca, so this is for SN8 apparently. Hopefully soon we might start seeing the SN8 prototype sections getting stacked. Unfortunately, not the longest video today. However, regardless, I would like to say a massive thank you to Mary Boca Chica Girl for the immense amount of hours she spends outside filming, particularly during live streams. Her dedication and the dedication of the other NSF members means we get to witness history as it's happening live. Thank you all so much for your work, we all appreciate it so much. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.